Bitachon. Having confidence in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that is a fundamental possession to have in order to even have a chance of ever acquiring Ruach HaKodesh. Now, who knows better than the Chofetz Chaim, Alav HaShalom, about the human mind and its flaws in his sefer called Shem Olam, in Chelek Aleph, Perek Gimel, 1-3. He says, if you ask a person, do you believe that Hashem is overseeing this lowly world? Surely the person will respond, of course. You ask a person, do you think Hashem's running the world? If that person is not an atheist or some type of mental case, I'll tell you, sure, of course. It's running the world. I mean, the world didn't come by itself. The plant didn't just appear. Even if you want to believe that somehow a rock turned into all life form once and never again, still, where did the first rock come from? And if the first rock came from God, why are you limiting this God then? If he can create this one rock that can turn into human life, then therefore he could also do anything else, which means that he doesn't need the rock to turn into human life. He can simply just make humans and just make everything. Once you understand that there has to be a God, there has to be a creator, why limit it? So you ask, the person's religious. Do you believe that God is overseeing everything? I'll tell you, sure, of course, I'm in, of course. We think of Kofel. Look at you funny. Why are you asking such a silly question? Of course I believe God believes. I wouldn't be a Jew if otherwise. Chofetz Chaim continues. Surely he'll respond, of course, but if we investigate further, we'll see that it's just the mouth speaking. But it's not really the same in his inner heart. Because if we really believed that God is monitoring everything, that God is watching everything, that God created everything, if we really believed that, there would never be theft. There would never be one Jew hurting another, one person hurting another. Because we know that Hashem is watching us. Right before you take that dollar, that $1 million, that whatever it is, from some place that doesn't belong to you. If you really believe that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching, you never take a single penny that's not yours. You'd never take a single penny that's not yours. Better yet, you'd never offend a single person. The second before you're about to just destroy this person that's in front of you because they did whatever they did to you. The second before you're about to curse this person out. The second before you're about to insult your own wife, your own husband, your own child. You realize that a Kadosh Baruch Hu's next to you. You're like, oh, hold on a second. I'm about to do this to his daughter, to his son. The second you understand that the King of Kings, the one that controls whether you live or die, the one who controls whether you have money or not, the one who controls whether you're gonna breathe one more second, the second you realize he's there watching, everything changes. Everybody has a lot of confidence in their future, but very few understand the reality. My dear father, God bless him, told me a story that, mamash, it broke my heart, but taught me a lot of musar. Just a few weeks ago, he says that there was a nice guy. He used to have lunch with him every single day. For 20 years, they were friends. For 20 years, they know each other or more. They work together, and, oh, HaShem, they have lunch together. They chit-chat every day. He says, you know, that day, my mom decided to make them sandwiches, and for my father to bring it to the office. Instead of ordering things, she made them sandwiches, and they're gonna eat together lunch anyway. So she made both of them sandwiches. Oh, HaShem, my mom has a big heart. So when she makes a sandwich, it's for two. But each sandwich. So she gives them two sandwiches for two people each. Shtabach Shimo. Sandwiches are the best sandwiches in the world. Now, she takes the sandwiches, they sit down, they have the typical lunch. Oh, HaShem, they talk, they chit-chat, ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. But it's a big sandwich, so I say, you know what? I'm going to finish the second half later. Okay, I'll see you later. My father is in his office. His friend, David, leaves. He says, I'll see you later, we'll eat together later, we'll finish the sandwich together later. So he goes about his business, and my father goes to his business, and he does whatever he does. A few hours pass, and he calls, no answer. Calls again, no answer, okay, maybe he's busy, calls again, no answer. He goes downstairs, he says, listen, you guys see David? Oh, you didn't know? No, what do you mean I didn't know? What happened? He just died. What? What do you mean he just died? He just died. He had a heart attack and he died in the middle of 47th Street. If that doesn't shock you, you have to check your pulse. A person has confidence that he's going to be here in 20 years, and therefore he prepares his 401k savings and his retirement plan and his stock accounts and his vacation house and his savings plan and his shoes and his clothes and his dreams and his aspirations. And the reality is he has no idea whether he's going to survive the next few hours to finish a sandwich. A sandwich. Rabotai. Satan is fooling all of us to think big. Why? When you think big about everything else, you forget the reality that's small and it's in front of you. And therefore, Rabotai Karim, the Chazonish tells us, if we knew who HaKadosh Baruch Hu is, if we really believed in Him, we would never steal. We would never hurt each other. We would know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching every single thing that we're doing, and we'd never perform a single mitzvah out of casualty or lackings in any mitzvah whatsoever. Our great sins have brought us to a point where we don't even delve into this matter, saying we believe even though we don't. This, Rabotai, is the Chofetz Chaim going inside your mind and telling you what you really think. You can tell yourself whatever you want. Chazonish went into your mind. Chofetz Chaim went into your mind, tells you, okay, I removed the Yetzirah for you. This is what the truth looks like. You think you believe. Reality, you have work to do.